Our local heroes, the healthcare workers on the front line, just as the volunteer firefighters did over summer, are showing us the way. Their courage, commitment, and compassion show the very best of Australia. Tonight, a grateful nation gives thanks. Mr. Speaker, mental health and suicide prevention is a national priority. My heart goes out to all those Australians, young and old, for whom COVID-19 has caused such pain. My message tonight is that this House stands with you. You are not alone. Around 7 million Medicare subsidised mental health services have been delivered since March. And tonight, we are doubling the number of Medicare funded psychological services through the Better Access Initiative from 10 to 20. We're providing more funding for Lifeline, for Headspace, for Beyond Blue, and for Kids Helpline. We're providing support for more young Australians with a mental illness to help them participate in the workforce. And these initiatives will bring our commitment to mental health to $5.7 billion this year. And this is not the last word. In coming weeks, we will release the Productivity Commission's mental health final report and the interim report into suicide prevention that was commissioned by the Prime Minister. These reports will guide our future actions, and working together with the states and the territories, we will save lives. We are guaranteeing healthcare and the essential services that Australians rely on. And we are doing this by growing the Australian economy, not increasing taxes. Mr. Speaker, together Australia will come back. Together we will rebuild the economy and secure Australia's future. I commend this bill to the House. Yeah.